Thank you. Thank you. So do you think that countries that have moved forward, like China, will continue moving forward? And could they be the new center of technological promise?
It was actually related to
your
that.
Name.
Yeah, Shubi. Hey, I work on engineering, machine learning, biometrics stuff. So my question is, do you think the stagnating rates of progress that we're observing in the US and Western democracies, that they serve as a bellwether to the rest of the world? Or are there different political and societal structures that might be able to bypass this phenomenon?
You sort of covered in that question, but like, are there alternatives to this?
I think that the sub question was basically because a lot of like Western democracy is basically based around consensus. I mean, would you like a lot of like scientific progress actually happened under like either monarchies or like other systems where like it was like benefactors that like, you know, could support the efforts of individuals that were making progress. So like, do you think that systems like that might need to like come back in some form or the other to like
Hi, I'm Cindy. I was trained as an economist. So my question is, basically the big question is like, what is the kind of progress that we want? And specifically, I guess I really like what you said about taking a humanistic approach of using progress to enhance human welfare, because a lot of times it's easy to focus just on like technology, but not all technology are equal. Some exacerbate X risk, like Alice mentioned, and some, you know, while, for example, fossil fuel, while driving growth, also leads to like issue of climate change. Some are just not, like you mentioned, someone was complaining, why don't we have flying cars? We have, I think this was somebody in VC was complaining a few years ago, like now we have all of these apps, but we don't have flying cars. So some, you know, some of the apps are good, but they are not, I guess, yeah, even if they don't really do harm, some of them just like, somehow they generate returns for investors, but they're not as good as enhancing human welfare than other kinds of technology. So, and I probably everyone here agrees that GDP growth also isn't, you know, that good metric of human welfare. So, if we want to take a humanistic approach of the, with the goal of enhancing human welfare and looking at progress, do we have a good idea of what kind of progress in terms of technology or other things are the ones that we want to pursue? Because I see progress studies as like maybe two components. One is to figure out what is it that we want to pursue, and two is like, how do we, you know, pursue that at a government level, philanthropy, and private sector level? So I wonder, yeah, like how much do we know about the first part of what is it we want to pursue, and if not, how do we go about understanding that? And by the way, I really like you emphasizing the humanist approach, because I think, yeah, like you said, a lot of people don't like progress, they don't like modernity, and that's probably because a lot of those things came with a lot of negative consequences, but if going forward, we are, at least the progress study movement is more conscious of that and emphasizes that, then a lot of the backlash would not happen. the